Problems on Cauchy's second theorem on limits show that limit of n to the power 1 by n as n tends to infinity is 1. That is, limit of nth root of n is 1. First of all, we have to write a n, the nth term of the given sequence. Whether it is a Cauchy's first theorem on limit or Cauchy's second theorem on limit, the very first step is to write an. How to write an, or how to choose an? Now the following idea will help us to choose an. An is given expression except the power 1 by n, leaving the limit. So what's the given expression? The given expression is n to the power 1 by n. In the given problem, the given expression is n to the power 1 by n. Now what is an then? Given expression except the power 1 by n. So we have to leave this 1 by n. We have to leave 1 by n. What is left over? Only n is left over. Therefore, an is n. One important thing here is, in the statement of Cauchy's second theorem on limits, the second hypothesis is limit of an by an minus 1 as n tends to infinity. But in the case of problems, we are going to take the ratio as an plus 1 by an. The reason is, if you have a an by an minus 1, an is okay. Then how do you get an minus 1? We have to replace each n by n minus 1. Addition is much easier than subtraction. Therefore, to avoid this subtraction, namely an minus 1, we will be using the second hypothesis of Cauchy's second theorem as an plus 1 by an. There will not be any difficulty in this. It won't make any changes in the statement also. Instead of writing an by an plus 1, we are going to write an plus 1 by an. That's it. Therefore, there will not be any problem. Therefore, an is n. What is an plus 1? It is n plus 1. So, n plus 1 by n, that is equals to 1 plus 1 by n. That is divided into two terms. We get n by n is 1 plus 1 by n. Taking limit on both sides. Limit of an plus 1 by an as n tends to infinity is limit of 1 plus 1 by n as n tends to infinity. Now we apply the limit. Since there is no n here, is purely constant. Therefore, we write 1 as it is. When you apply limit to the second term, namely 1 by n, 1 by n, n tends to infinity. Therefore, this n should be replaced by infinity. So, it is equals to 1 plus 1 by infinity. What is 1 by infinity? 1 by infinity tends to 0. 1 by infinity tends to 0. Therefore, it is nothing but 1 plus 0, that is equals to 1. By Cauchy's second theorem on limit, what is the statement? The statement says that if an, the sequence an, such that an is greater than 0 for all n. It is true here. What is an? An is n. What is n? N belongs to capital N. That is, n is a natural number. Therefore, a1 is 1, positive. a2 is 2, positive. a10 is 10, positive. a100 is 100, positive. That is, each and every term of the sequence is positive. That is, the first hypothesis satisfied. What was the second one? Limit of an by an minus 1 as n tends to infinity is L. Here, what is this? The limit of, as I told you, in the place of an by an minus 1, we are going to take an plus 1 by an while doing problems. Okay. Therefore, limit of an plus 1 by an as n tends to infinity is 1. Then what does the statement say? The conclusion of the statement is limit of nth root of an is also 1. Limit of nth root of an is 1. What is an? An is n. And hence, by this theorem, we will get nth root of an must be 1. What is an? N. And hence, limit of nth root of n as n tends to infinity is 1. Now, we will show that limit of 1 plus root 2 plus cubic root of 3 plus 4th root of 4 plus so on plus nth root of n divided by n as n tends to infinity is 1. If you look at this, what is this? First term, second term, third term, fourth term, nth term by n. This is look like arithmetic mean of n terms. Arithmetic mean of n terms. That is a1, a2, a3, a4, so on. This is nth term, namely an. A suffix n. Therefore, here we have to use Cauchy's first theorem on limits. We have to choose an. What is an? What is an? Just now we discussed an is the nth term of the given expression, namely an. What is an? Nth root of n. That is an. What is the limit of an? The limit of an as n tends to infinity is limit of nth root of n tends to infinity is equals to the nth root of n can be rewritten as n to the power 1 by n. So what is the value of limit of nth root of n as n tends to infinity? It is 1. Just now we have proved in problem 1, we have shown that limit of nth root of n is 1 by power number 1. Therefore, by Cauchy's first theorem on limit, we have limit of an is L as n tends to infinity, then limit of arithmetic mean of first n term is also L. Now we have derived, we get the limit of nth term as L. Limit of nth term is L. But what is L here? L is 1. So limit of nth term is 1. And hence by Cauchy's first theorem, limit of the arithmetic mean is also L. That is L equal to 1. L equal to 1. Therefore, limit of a1 plus a2 plus an by n as n tends to infinity is same as limit of, what is a1? a1 is nothing but 1. What is a2? a2 is nothing but root 2. What is a3? a3 is nothing but cubic root of 3. What is an? Nth root of n whole divided by n. That's the one we have written here. That's the one we have written here. And hence, that is equals to 1. That is equals to 1. Thus, limit of the arithmetic mean of n terms, namely 1 plus root 2 plus cubic root of 3 plus 4th root of 4 plus nth root of n by n as n tends to infinity is